So I had a whole video planned about how I was going to come back, but that didn't go the way I wanted it to, so we're just going to do this instead. Now, I know, it's been a couple years since I've been on YouTube, but we're just going to keep on rolling with it like I never left. Today, we're going to be chopping down our cover crop, which is this sorghum grass, and I'll take you along the journey. So yeah, like I said, we'll be chopping down our cover crop here. I've been doing this since first thing this morning. It's about 1:10 now. I think I've gotten 3 fields done so far. Well, this is the third one I'm working on now. But yeah, this is the chopper behind me. And I thought, why not now to film a YouTube video? The majority of the farms in my area use sorghum as a cover crop. I know up north, a lot of farmers, they use it as feed for their cattle. They can bale it, use it for silage and stuff. But that's really the only use we have for it here in North Florida. The reason we plant sorghum as a cover crop is because it adds a little bit of nutrients after having the potatoes come out of there. The potatoes don't add any nutrients whatsoever to the ground, and it also helps prevent erosion. So yeah, I'm just gonna kind of give you a run through of how I'm doing this. This is an 8-row stalk chopper. We just put new blades on it, so it's chopping pretty nicely. Going to turn into our rows here. You count 3 rows and then you count 2 more and you turn in on those 2 like that. Get it straight and let your chopper down and then give it a little gas and you take off. I'm running it in 4th gear, about 1850 RPMs. But yeah, that's pretty much all I'm doing. Get up when you get to the end, bump down your gears. Turning around is a little bit rough because the chopper's so heavy, it bounces around. The tractor bounces around, so you bounce around. We all bounce around. Kind of have to get a feel for what your rows are sometimes. So there's 2 jobs that I really enjoy doing here on the farm. That's planting and knocking down this cover crop. So mesmerizing watching it all fall down. You can see it all going down behind us. It's doing a really good job. So after we chop all our cover crop down, we'll let it sit for about a month before we come in here and start plowing the ground and working it. We have that board on the front of the tractor to help push the stalks down before they get to the front of the tractor here. If we didn't, there would be a lot more trash in the radiator screen. There still is some, but not as much as there would be if we didn't have the board. And quite a bit's changed since I've been gone about the farm and me. I think I was about 16 going on 17 whenever I stopped uploading YouTube videos. So yeah, now I'm 19 and I hope this year to film a lot of the growing process. And this is kind of the first step to doing so. That's this field done. All right, so now I'm gonna fold up the chopper. We're gonna hit the road and head to the next field. At the next field now, going back at it again. All you farmers out there, you know the feeling of trying to get a wide piece of equipment down the road. A narrow one at that. Every once in a while, I like to get out, look around, see what kind of a job the piece of equipment is doing. And I also like to look at the piece of equipment I'm running. The main thing I usually check is the bearings. We just put new bearings on here as well. So they all should be good, but you never know. I'm also checking to make sure this reel here hasn't walked over either way and starts hitting the side of that wall or down there. Quite a lot going on. Well, everything looks pretty good with the chopper. I'm just gonna stop right here at the bathroom and then we'll get back to work. There are patchy spots in the sorghum like this here. It could be because of lack of nutrients in the soil. Moisture or even the weeds and grass taking all the nutrients away from the plant itself. We may apply some nitrogen to it, some fertilizer in rare cases, but most times we plant it and just let it grow. There's low spots, and then there's spots like this where it's sitting way above the cab of the tractor. Kind of feels like I'm going through a jungle. But yeah, this is just kind of a short video to show you guys what's going on out here on the farm. I hope to be uploading more often. Hopefully this is the start of me doing that. And if you guys like the video, let me know in the comments down below. Moose out.